हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वेरी फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ एचटीएमएल प्रोग्रामिंग। आई एम शेखर सिन्हा एंड यू आर लर्निंग एचटीएमएल प्रोग्रामिंग विद मी इन द सीरीज ऑफ एचटीएमएल प्रोग्रामिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट। इन ओवरव्यू ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट फर्स्ट वी विल लुक एट द सिलेबस प्रोवाइडेड टू अस एंड देन आफ्टर the introduction of HTML and finally the most important question we will see why we should learn HTML. So let's start. So there are total 7 units provided to you. The first one unit is HTML programming. In that section we will learn the intro and terminologies, and in the introduction part we will also look at the history of the HTML, how it come into existence, how it is evaluated, and then after the various terminologies related to the internet, intranet and extranet. So all over, and then after the most important also the www, world wide web, that we will see one by one in the terminologies section. The second unit, it deals with the basics of HTML. Basics of HTML means how tags are used, how you should start HTML, where you should type the codes, and how you should run it. Fine. And then the third unit is list. The very first, perhaps you have seen in the MS Word, the various types of lists are bullets are there, where you are writing the point wise something. Some are unordered, means you can see in the various shapes like square, disk and tick, like the various other bullets are there. And apart from that, that some ordered lists are also there, that are like 1 2 3, Roman 1 2 3, like that. So that we will learn in that section, how we will create that, how we can create that so that it can appear in the website or web page. The next unit is links. Whenever you will go through the any website on the net, you can see the there are different links there, where you can click on those links and you can jump to the next page. So links are basically hyperlinks that we will learn how to create it. Even we can create this link on a image also. The next unit is images. Images means there are various types of images. Suppose if you want to learn how to put images on the net, web page, so how you can do that, there are different tags for that, and you will learn image tag is there, and that you can learn how to put various images in your web page and place it at a particular place. Then after, you will also learn how to make an image as a background, okay, and then also you will learn how to make image as a clickable image. Then after, the next unit is tables, the most important part of the web page. Whenever you are trying to create a web page, you should place each and every content at a proper place. So to place different contents on a proper place, you should use tables. The tables are quite easy, that you should know only this is a table, on the top to bottom the vertical lines are known as columns, the horizontal lines are known as rows, and the intersection of rows and columns are known as cells. That's it, only you have to know, and then you can work very easily on that. The next unit is form and CSS. Whenever you will go through any website like the Gmail, Yahoo, you have perhaps seen a form there, sign in form, sign up form. Okay, so how they are created? They are created actually using forms. Forms actually, it's a tag which provides the various buttons, check boxes, text boxes, like. And CSS is cascading style sheet. CSS is what? It's a cascading style sheet. Mean, through this you can format your web page. Okay, so that these 7 units we will learn one by one, and then after the intro of HTML. That after the intro of HTML. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. Here hypertext means a jumping text which is called link, And markup language is enclosing your contents, your text within a tag. The next one, it is used to write web pages. You are creating web page using the notepad and then you are producing it in a browser like Internet Explorer, Chrome, Mozilla, Firefox, like those. And then the next point is the link available on a web page is called hypertext. So hyper means the jumping word or linking word, and text is that text, particular text through which you will create a link. It's a quite easy. Next we will learn in that. The next point is markup language means HTML simply mark up a text document with tags and that tell a web browser how to structure it to display. It means markup language when you are using tags and then you are writing your content, mean opening tag and closing tag, and in between those things you will write your content. So those tags will tell the browser mean, and then browser will interpret those tags and it will display the contents in the web browser appropriately. Okay. The next point is HTML was created by Tim Berners-Lee. It was created by Tim Berners-Lee in the late 1991, but it was HTML 1.0 which was not produced in 1991, but HTML 2.0 was the first standard HTML specification which was published in 1995. So we have to keep in mind HTML 1.0 was not published, HTML 2.0 was published in 1995. Then HTML 3.0 came. It came with the show facilities, but it slowed down the browser. So then after again it was improved, and HTML 4.0, a major version of HTML, was published in ni late 1999. And currently HTML 5 version is used, an extension of HTML 4.01. Right now we are using HTML 5.2 in 2014. HTML 5.0 was published in 2012. But still, this time we are using HTML 5.2 in 2000 since 2014, right? So let's see the next why we should learn HTML, because it's simple, easy to learn and implement. If you are looking for your professional career in a domain or in a web development, in a web career, if you are trying to find it, you should learn HTML. It's a quite simple. I mean, you can write your tags, your codes in a notepad, and you can display it in a browser. The next point is we can create a website or customize an existing web template. It means it says that from the scratch you can create a website. Website is what is a collection of web pages, or you can edit any existing web template and you can create your own. Then after, the next point is if you want to start a career as a professional web designer, HTML and CSS designing is a must skill. So if you want to create if you want to sorry look at your career as a professional web designer, you should learn HTML and CSS more. That's why the HTML is very important. To optimize your website to boost its speed and performance, know HTML to yield best result. It says that if you want to create a website, and then after, if you want that it should come with a lightweight, it should have very good speed, it should be optimized with the performance, then you should use HTML. Okay. The next is it is platform independent. It means you can write it in any text editor, and it can run on any browser. There is no need to go with a particular browser. The next point is image, audio, video can be added very easily. So you can format your web page with the images, with the audio, with the embedded video, with the external link video. And then the after HTML, other related technologies like JavaScript, PHP, etc. become very easier to understand. Once you have learnt HTML, एक बार आपने HTML सीख लिया, तो उसके बाद आप JavaScript लगाएं, PHP लगाएं, और ये बहुत आसान हो जाता है समझना। सो द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज टू वर्क एनीवेयर इन द वेब डेवलपमेंट. आप पूरे वेब डेवलपमेंट के डोमेन में उस पूरे एरिया में आप कुछ भी बने, वेब एनालाइजर बने, वेब डिज़ाइनर बने, वेब डेवलपर बने, आपको एचटीएमएल जानना होगा. सो राइट नाउ हम लोगों ने देख लिया कि 7 यूनिट्स क्या क्या हैं और किस में हमें क्या क्या पढ़ना है. देन आफ्टर वी हैव लर्न कि इंट्रो में क्या होता है, ठीक है, और एचटीएमएल क्यों पढ़ना चाहिए, ठीक है. इन द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन वी विल स्टार्ट विद द वेरी फर्स्ट यूनिट, इंट्रोडक्शन एंड टर्मिनोलॉजीज. टिल देन थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.